Okay, we are two of us here. One is from ICTS and myself from ICPS. So, with regard to the status of our department, in case of child protection, the government has already a website developed through MWCD. And ministry is already planning, like with regard to mobile apps for tracking and reporting of missing children. Then side by side, we are presenting.
I'm presenting the ICPS part. As of now, mobile has not been used for the ICPS project. But very soon we are in the transition phase. Actually, it is transforming into a mission mode. So we are trying to strengthen the current structure and system as of now. So in the process, what we have done is that we have in our website, we have tried to fit in all the contact numbers of all our Anganwadi workers. Not just our Anganwadi workers, but right from the topmost functionary, that is the CDPO, to the Anganwadi workers, which would be helpful in contacting them. But still, it is under process, so a lot has to be done yet.
As I said already, ICPS already has a website through which, we are tracking the children missing. Missing children especially, and also we are it is a database for all the children who are in the CCIs, child care institutes, reporting the missing child and the children in need of care and protection. So, and we are
registering
the decision. Pardon? Reporting. Yeah, anyone can report through the there is a citizen's corner through which you can report a missing child or a child you have found anywhere else.
ICT plays a very important role in the entire ICDS project. If we see, we have main six services, that is, we provide preschool education, supplementary nutrition program, health checkup, referral, health and nutrition education, and immunization. So the way our case is, that is, CINI has been providing them with tablets through which they have been feeding in data, which is helping us to develop an overview of the entire situation. So similar initiatives can be taken in our project as well, because for us the most important indicators would be referral services, health checkup, and supplementary nutrition program, as well as the growth monitoring program. Because if we see that malnourishment is one of the major problems that is being faced by the children of our state as well as the country. So through this, because there has been a lacuna in the reporting of cases. So through, and also there's a lot of time consumption which takes place, and efficiency is also reduced. So in such a case that if some technological intervention is being made, then the data reporting would be much easier and much faster.
With the usage of mobile, through SMSs, it would be of great help if we could create awareness in the rural society about our issues, especially with regard to child protection. With regard to ICPS, information regarding child protection and child rights, through SMS and IVRS, could be sent across, in order to track any child who is in need of care and protection, to prevent any kind of child trafficking, child labor, child marriage, or anything else. And for this, for supporting frontline workers, block level child protection committees we have got. So these committees can be enhanced with the usage of mobile phones and other mobile applications.
Nutrition. And nutrition is one major factor which is also the cause of malnutrition in the country. So, and also apart from that, we have been talking about the high MMR in the state. So, and one of our main core services is providing maternal health care to the mothers. So, health checkups and referral services. So, through this, the process will become much easier. And also, if you see that how it will help us, basically it will help us, because if you see that the Anganwadi workers, they are, we have been talking about using the Anganwadi workers and their facilities for almost every other facility, every other services that we are trying to impart to the, or we are trying to give to the community. But we also have to notice this fact that they are burdened with almost 11 registers, which are very complex and comprehensive. So in such a case that if we provide them, if we are able to provide them with something which kind of reduces their input or effort and will and make things easier for them, will be definitely beneficial for the project itself.
Capacity and developmental needs. Like we'd like to have like a basic training for the frontline workers, like training on how to report, then identification of case by the frontline workers.
For ICDS, we have 62,153 Anganwadi centers all over the state. So, and also this Anganwadi centers, they are not located within a very small area, so the area it covers is also very huge. So in such a case, the things which will be required for using technology in this sector would be probably, first of all, if we are planning to give it to the Anganwadi workers, we'll see that the eligibility criteria for recruitment of Anganwadi workers is that they have to be 10th pass, basically. So their knowledge about technology is very less, if we see. So in such a case that we have to provide them with user-friendly technology or simpler technology which is easier for them to understand. Secondly, training is one very important component that has to be done. And also seeing the now kind of numbers that we are trying to use this technology for, it has to be cost effective. We cannot provide them with some technology which is really very high on price.
A key support and partnership required. Like ICPS is already having the partnership with UNICEF, and also would like to seek would like to work with other grassroots NGOs. And trainings are needed for the grassroots workers and frontline workers from technical organizations.
The immediate steps that should be taken is that, first of all, we have to collaborate with any organization which will provide us with technology which will support our services. Secondly, our responsibility will be definitely for monitoring and evaluation. Then the parameters improvisation required, like for the project that is Girl Power, they have used the main parameters that they have used are security and education. But for us, we have to develop it according to our own parameters. That is, we have taken four parameters, basically supplementary health, nutrition, and referral health checkup and growth monitoring. And then, of course, we'll need a lot of support because ICDS, it's, as it is that we are trying to cover the entire health of mother as well as the child up to the age of 6 years. So a lot of departments will have to work in collaboration.
So I have got another presentation with regard to track child. They had it was a successful pilot implementation in West Bengal. In later on in 2012 and 13, it was launched nationally. And basically, Track Child is it holds live data of missing and found children, and also children who are in the CCIs, children child care institutes. So it is designed in line with the Juvenile Justice Care and Protection Act and the model rules of 2007. And this website provides a virtual space for these stakeholders. So all these stakeholders, they have got a space, so they can log in. They have got their login ID, password. So like all the central level, state level, district level, and subdivisional level, block level, and even up to the village level. objectives of the objective main objectives of this Tech Child is tracking of missing children and also to like repatriate and rehabilitate the missing children to ensure proper care and development of the children in need of care and protection in the living in the child care institutes and to set up a framework for participating organizations involved in the process. The features of Tech Child are this. This is a central data repository. So all the data can be like seen at the central level as well as at like a state level, district level. So at every level the data can be seen. So it is an online repository facility for missing and found children. Then there is a like an interface of a citizen to inform any child like who is missing or sighted at any place. Then there is an electronic alert system for stakeholders including email, SMS alert. Facility to match found children. So if any children who is found can be matched with the missing. Then there is an online SMS system there as well as a chat room. Facility to monitor overall progress and development of all the child care institutes. So online data sharing with stakeholders. So like if all the data are fed like by CWCs at the district level, child welfare committees, and also we have got juvenile justice boards, then child care institutes and police. So these are the stakeholders who are feeding the data of all the children who are missing and found. So once they feed the data, data can be shared with other stakeholders like Ministry of Home Affairs, Department of Home, then Labour and Employment, then we have the District Child Protection Units, DWCDs, State Child Protection Society, MWCD, Police. So data can be shared with all the stakeholders. Then the latest, we had the earlier version of Track Child 1.0. Now the new version has come, 1.6. So in this version, they have introduced mobile apps. So through the apps, any child who is found missing can be like reported using the mobile apps. So this app can be found in the Google Play Store and NIC App Store for downloading. Then SMS alert system sends alert messages to predefined stakeholders for initiating prompt action at the end for addressing the issue. So this is, as I said, this is a new, newly introduced thing. So like we have still not used it and hope soon we'll be using it. And major challenges like we found in this using this Track Child is like ensuring 100% reporting of cases. So like it's very difficult to ensure 100% reporting and capturing of details of cases, like all the details. Sometimes it is difficult to capture all the details of the cases. Then matching of missing and found children. Unless the data of the missing children are fed in, we can't match the children who are missing. So this is my short presentation. Thank you.